In this lesson, we're going to be performing matrix operation, section 6.3. So a matrix is a rectangular array of numbers arranged in rows and columns. So sometimes we use notation for matrices to label them, to give them a name. We haven't done that yet, but if we're talking about multiple matrices at one time, it's good to identify which matrix we're talking about. So usually uppercase letters or capital letters, okay, such as A, B, or C, could be used to name the matrices. So a lowercase letter enclosed in brackets, such as like this, lowercase a, and it has subscripts of I, J, that refers to what row and what column that element is in. Where a subscript ij refers to the element in the ith row and the jth column. We've already seen what an order is of a matrix. It identifies the number of rows and columns, where M and N are the rows and the columns. We know that if the rows equal the number of columns, then we have a square matrix. So in this example, what is the order of the matrix? Well, how many rows and how many columns? So what is it asking when it says identify lowercase a subscripts 2, 3? 2 represents the row, 3 represents the column. So what number in this matrix is in the second row, third column? So drop down to the second row and then count over to the third column. That element is negative 5. So try this one. What element is in the third row, first column? Okay, further, what's an equality of two matrices? So two matrices are equal if and only if they have the same order. And what this is saying right here is that every element in the every element in one matrix is the same value as the element in the other matrix. So corresponding elements have to be equal in those matrices. So two matrices are equal if and only if they have the same order and corresponding elements are equal. So here's an example. If I have matrix A that names this matrix, and I have matrix B that names this matrix, and we say that A is equal to B, then A is equal to B only if and only if X right here is equal to 12. And then if right here, Y plus 3 has to equal 5. And then corresponding elements here in this position, lower left, 2z has to equal 6, and then 8 has to equal 8. So I can see that 8 equals 8 for sure. So x has to be equal to 12, got it. Y plus 3 has to equal 5. So that means y has to have a value of 2 here to equal this 5. And if I have 2z and 6 here, it has to be true that z is equal to 3 when I divide both sides by 2, so that I get 6 here and 6 here. All right, we can perform matrix addition and subtraction, and so that's going to be the focus next up to this point right here. So the important thing to pay attention to is when you add and subtract matrices, you can only add and subtract if the matrices that you're adding or subtracting have the same order. Same rows and same columns. And then all we do is we just add or subtract corresponding elements in the matrices. So for example, we have given matrix A, matrix B, and matrix C. For matrix A, this order is 3 rows and 2 columns. Here we have 3 rows and 2 columns. Matrix C is 2 rows and 2 columns. Perform the indicated matrix operations. Can I add matrix A to matrix B? Well, the requirement is I have the same order. A and B have the same order. So it's a pretty simple addition. So you would add 4 to 3 and record. Corresponding elements, when I sum these two, would be 5. Add these two numbers. These two numbers, they're in the same position. Here and here. So this is the sum A plus B. Okay, can I subtract? Can I do B minus A? Well, yes, both B and A have the same order. So for me, I don't know, I would probably put the B matrix first. Right now I see A is before B, but for me, I'd probably re-record the B matrix right here. I just like B to come first. Just be careful so you don't make a, transcription error. So this is B minus A. You don't have to do this, it just helps me organize everything. So here's going to be my answer, B minus A. So I just take 3 and I subtract 4. I take 6 and subtract negative 1. Negative 4 minus 2. 2 minus 5. Negative 1 minus negative 3. Use your calculator. 5 minus 1 is 4. All right, can I add A and C matrix? No, A and C don't have the same order, so we say that there's no solution. You could respond undefined, but there's no answer. So adding and subtracting matrices are pretty straightforward. It's kind of intuitive. Okay, let's move on. We've got some multiplication to do with matrices. There's two types of multiplication that we're going to look at with matrices. One is called scalar multiplication. Kind of a fancy word. It just means that you're going to multiply a matrix by the same number. So any matrix A can be multiplied by a scalar, which is just another way to say a constant. So each element of that matrix is multiplied by that constant. So the new matrix is called a scalar multiple of A. So example, use matrices A, B, and C from the example above to find the following matrices. Well, that's going to continue on the back. I just couldn't fit it all on the same page. So remember, in the examples that we're about to do, we're going to have to flip back and look at these matrices right here. Here's our example. Negative 2 times matrix A. That just means double or multiply every element in matrix A by negative 2. You just kind of have to flip back to that. Again, these numbers just came from my multiplying matrix A by negative 2. Okay, this one's a little bit more involved. I'm going to double matrix A and triple matrix B, and then after I do that, then I'm going to add them together. So you don't have to do what I'm doing. You can do it all on the calculator, double A's elements and then triple B's, and then add it together and record the answer. But for me, I just kind of like to visualize it. So right here, I'm going to have the 2A matrix. And my operation is addition, and I'm going to put 3B here. And then this matrix is going to be the answer matrix. So I've already doubled and tripled. Now all that's left for me to do is add these two numbers here in the corresponding spots. That's scalar multiplication. Probably the most cumbersome operation with matrices, in my opinion, would be the the matrix multiplication. Not with the scalar, but trying to multiply two matrices together. It requires a little more work. It's a little more tedious. Okay, so what are the requirements for us to multiply two matrices together? I can only multiply two matrices together if the corresponding orders, meaning if A's order and B's order, fits this description. So M and N are the rows and columns of matrix A. So that's matrix A. And I'm going to use two different letters of the alphabet, N and P, to represent the order of matrix B. However, notice this. In the first matrix A, then this is rows, this is columns, the number of columns in matrix A has to match the number of rows in the matrix B. So rows, columns in matrix A have to be the same number as the number of rows in matrix B. Okay, so the number of columns of A must equal the number of rows of B. If the columns of the first matrix does not equal the rows of the second matrix, multiplication is impossible. If these two numbers aren't the same when we define the order, then we just are out of the problem and we say you can't multiply. This says that the product will have this new order, M times P. Well, let's look back at this formula. If the columns and the rows are the same, then my answer matrix is going to be M and P. That would be my rows, and that'll be the columns of my answer matrix if I can multiply. And then it says matrix multiplication is not commutative, meaning if you multiply A times B, it's not necessarily true that when you take B and multiply by A, that's going to be the same. It might be in some cases it is, depending upon each individual matrix, A and B, but probably oftentimes it's not. I think the best way to kind of work through this is just do a lot of examples. So this is the generic notation for multiplying A and B. So just kind of defining what's going on here, and then we'll apply it to these examples. So let's say that matrix A is right here. This is matrix A. And let's say matrix B is this 2x2 matrix here. Now, remember, it says matrix A's order is 2x2, and matrix B's order is also 2x2. So do the number of columns in matrix B, this number, equal the number of rows, this number, in matrix B? Yes, they do, which means that this is going to be the order of my answer matrix, 2x2, which when you look at this answer matrix, okay, that's going to be one number, a second number, another number, and another number. This is two rows and two columns. Let's see if we can figure out where this came from. This says we're going to multiply A times E. Well, here's A and here's E. And then we're going to add that to the product of B times G, and G's right here. Basically, what you're doing is you're taking the rows in matrix A, and you're multiplying it by all the columns in matrix B. So we take rows from the first matrix, matrix A, and we take only columns from the second matrix. So if I multiply this row by this column, I start with the first element in the row and the column, multiply, AE, plus, not subtraction, plus the product of the second element in this row and the second element in this column, BG. So this position right here in this answer matrix is, this answer is going to be in row one, and then this number is going to be in column one. That's the position of that number. Okay, where did this come from? Well, we multiplied A times F, and then B times H. So then we take this row, and next we multiply it by that column. So AF plus BH, row one, column two. So this is row one in matrix A and column two in matrix B. So row one, column two, which is where this position is in this answer matrix. It's row one, column two. All right, where did these two entries come from? Well, now I'm going to shift down and I'm going to choose the next row in matrix A, which is CD. But now I've got to multiply this row times column one, put the answer here. And then I'm going to go back to this row and multiply it by this column. So let's see if that's what's happening here. So row two, which this is row two of my answer matrix, and in column one, I take row two, column one, C times E plus D times G. So looking at this position in my answer matrix, this number is going to be in row two, column two, which means I take row two from my first matrix, CD, and I apply and multiply it to my second column. So CF multiplies, that's what this is, plus DH, that's what that is right there. It's very important to stay organized, kind of work slow, get your calculator handy too. All right, let's just do some examples. So given matrix A, which is 2x2, given matrix B, which is also 2x2, Given matrix C, which is a column matrix, which has three rows and one column, three rows, one column, matrix D has order 2 times 3. Okay, can we multiply A times B? Well, the only way we can multiply A times B is if the columns in A match the number of rows in B. So what I would suggest is coming over here, putting the orders in front of you. A is 2 by 2 and B is 2 by 2. Are these, this is rows, columns, rows, columns. Are these two numbers the same? I'm just kind of lightly crossing them off. Yeah, they are. So my answer matrix is going to be a 2 by 2. So my suggestion would be to kind of keep things organized is to create an answer matrix that would have 2 rows and 2 columns. So that's what this would look like. 2 rows, 2 columns. I might also suggest that label where this blank is in this answer matrix. This blank is in row 1, column 1. This blank is row 1, column 2. These blanks down here, row 2, column 1. This position is in row 2, column 2. Okay, now for me to find the answers that go here, I've got to go back to my matrix A, only choose rows, row 1. I want this answer. So this comes from row 1, and then columns come from the second matrix. So we multiply 1 times 4, and we add that to 3 times 1. I'm gonna do the setup here and the answers here. So where do I get this answer from? Well, row 1, column 2. So row 1, but now row 1 gets multiplied into the second column. So 1 times 6 plus 3 times 0. All right, what is this blank? It's row 2, column 1. Now I've exhausted multiplying this row times every column. So now it's time for me to shift down and take the second row containing 2, 5, multiplying it by this column, and then lastly that column. So 2 times 4 plus 5 times 1. Row 2, which is here, column 2, which is now this column. 2 times 6 plus 5 times 0. And we'll do a little cleanup. Go to your calculator, that's gonna be 7. That's 6 plus 0, which is just 6. 8 plus 5 is 13. 12 plus 0 is just 12. Okay, what if we wanted to multiply matrix B times matrix A? Well, the dimensions of B are 2 by 2, and the dimensions of A are also 2 by 2. So I have the same columns in the first matrix as I have the rows in the second matrix. So yes, because these are the same, I can multiply and my answer matrix will be a 2 by 2. I might first rewrite matrix B and A. I like to see B first. And then matrix A. And yes, I can multiply these. And my answer matrix will be a 2 by 2. Sometimes I think it's helpful to label these positions. So this is row 1, column 1, etc. This helps keep you on point as far as how do I get this number. I get this number by taking row 1 for matrix B and multiplying it by column 1 for matrix A. Remember, only rows and only columns here. So 4 times 1 plus 6 times 2. Now row 1 matched with column 2, 4 times 3 plus 6 times 5. Now we're dropping down to row 2, which means we have to drop down to row 2 here. Thank goodness there's a 0. Now let's multiply row 2 times column 1. So 1 times 1 plus 0 times 2. And lastly, 1 times 3 plus 0 times 5. So 4 plus 12 is 16. 12 plus 30, 42. That's 1. That's 0 anyway. That's 3. Some of you might be able to go straight from the problem to the answer. That's fine. But if you forget, you know, how to go from here to here, these strategies might help you when you label the answer matrix. Okay. Part C, which product is possible? CD, DC, or neither? If one is possible, find the product. Okay, so for over here, I'm going to do C's dimensions back in the given are 3 by 1. D's dimensions back up here are 2 by 3. Well, columns don't match rows, so this product is not possible. Now let's rearrange the orders of D and C. So first I'm going to put 2 by 3 and then C's order. I say dimensions, but it's synonymous with the order. 2 by 3 and then up front would be 3 by 1. Yes, I can multiply D times C. So I'm going to take the D matrix and pull it down here and put it in front of me. And C is your column matrix. So I'm multiplying these two. So because I can multiply these two, the columns and the rows are the same, the leftover numbers create your answer matrix. So my answer matrix is going to be 2 rows by 1 column. So I'm going to build that 2 rows, 1 column. So 2 rows, 1 column. 2 rows, 1 column, got it. So this is row 1, column 1, and this is row 2, column 1. So how do I multiply over here? Choose only rows and multiply it by every column. There's only one. But now notice there's 3 elements here and 3 elements here. That's okay. We have 3 multiplications. So 2 times 1 plus 0 times 3 plus 4 times 7. Drop down to row 2. Okay, we've exhausted row 1 with every column because there's only one. Now drop down here and multiply these 3 numbers by the corresponding elements here. So not really corresponding, but this first element times this first element, etc. So 1 times 1 plus the 3 gets multiplied by the 3 plus the last number gets multiplied by that last number, -1 times 7. So this is going to go to 0. So 2 plus 28, I get 30. 1 plus 9 is 10. And this is minus 7. 10 minus 7 is 3. Okay, a couple more examples. Find, if possible, the following matrices. Let's look at the order for A and B. A's order, this is A, 2 rows, 4 columns. B's order is 4 rows, 2 columns. Yes, we're going to be able to multiply A times B because the columns and the rows match, and my answer matrix is going to be a 2 by 2. Okay, since A is first and B is second, I'm not going to rewrite the problems. I'm just going to go ahead and get right to the multiplication. So my answer matrix, build that first. It's 2 rows and 2 columns. So 2 by 2. I'm just saying where this blank is, where its position is. All right, so row 1 times column 1. So go to the A matrix, row 1, column 1 here. Notice you have 4 entries and 4 entries here. So I'm gonna have 4 products and then sum them. So multiply these two. Next, multiply these 2 numbers. Third, multiply those numbers, and then multiply those and sum them all. That's a times. I might use parentheses because of that negative. -1 times 1. looks like I didn't leave myself enough room here. There should be four products here. I'm gonna go right to the answer using a calculator nearby. So when I do all of this work right here, I'm gonna get 18. Okay, so for row one, column two, it's row one times column two. So on my IKEA post-it, I have it all worked out and expanded. I must have saved myself enough room. But on this, I'm running out of room, but you can consult that if you're kind of struggling with where, you know, the numbers are coming from. All right, I want to fill in this answer right here. So row one, column two, so that's, this product is four plus negative one is three. Plus negative 12 is negative 9, plus that product is 10, so that answer is going to be a 1. Okay, to get this answer, I need row 2 and column 1, so I'm done with this row. So let's do this row with this column, and then for the final answer, this row with this column. So negative 1 plus 0 plus negative 6 is negative 7. Negative 7 plus 6 is negative 1. I just don't have room right here to write it all out, but just check the key if need be. Last row with last column, 2 plus 0 plus 8 is 10, 10 plus 5 more is 15. All right, to complete this problem, let's check to see if we can do B times A. Okay, so going back to the original matrices, this order is 1, 2, 3, 4 by 2. Four rows, two columns, and then this, I'm gonna put that first. Let me do this. B is 4 by 2. A is 2 by 4. So columns, rows, yep, my answer is gonna be a 4 by 4 matrice. So what I'm gonna do to finish that problem is I'm gonna go to a different sheet of paper because I don't have room there. Okay, and I'm gonna work it out. So multiply B times A. So let me get B in front of me. And then A. So again, this is 4 by 2, and this is 2 by 4. So rows, columns, my answer matrix. Oh, let me push this up, so sorry. There we go. My answer matrix is gonna be a 4 by 4. So I go ahead and get that ready. I do 4 rows and 4 columns. Whoo. And I know it's kind of tedious, but it's very helpful if you label the position of each of these blanks requiring an answer. So this is row one, column one, etc. Probably should have left some space. It's gonna get crowded. Okay, let's see if we can make sense of this though. How do I get this number right here? Choose row one, multiply it by column one. To get that number, it's row one matched with this column. And then this row, that column, that row, that column. And each row and column only have two entries, so it shouldn't be too difficult. So negative 2 plus 2. Now let's match this row with this column. So positive 1 plus 0. And then here, negative 3 plus negative 4 is negative 7. And then negative 2 plus 2 looks to be 0. All right, now let's drop down to row 2 and matrix B. So matching this row with all 4 of these columns. 2 plus 1 is 3. Negative 1 plus 0. I'm here. 3 plus negative 2 is 1. 2 plus 1 is 3. Drop down to the third row, which is going to generate these answers when you multiply by each of these columns. So 6 plus negative 4 is 2. Where am I at? Column 2. Negative 3. Oh, good. That's a 0. 9 plus 8, 17. 6 plus negative 4 is 2. And row 4. 12 plus 5, 17. Negative 6 plus 0. 18 plus negative 10, 8. 12 plus 5 is 17. All right. So we just looked at different operations, adding, subtracting, the requirements to be able to add and subtract matrices. We looked at scalar multiplication, the easiest of all the multiplications. And then we looked at the requirements necessary if we're going to multiply a matrix, two matrices together.